Okay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome you to Arthur Davis Field on the campus of Central Methodist University, where today the Central Methodist men's soccer team takes on Graceland there. Quentin Norris here today. Central Methodist is 1-0 in the conference. Graceland is 3-0 and 1-0 in the conference. The coaches for Central Methodist is Alex Nichols. For Graceland is Brian Courtney. What a thrilling start there as well. Today's sponsors are sponsored by Braun Funeral Home, MFA Oil, Jennings Premium Meat, Addison Laboratory, CNR Supermarket, Drury Inns and Suite, KMOU TV Channel 8. Central Methodist, they are 1-0. They started out the season this past Wednesday, defeating Benedictine 4-0 down in Atchison, Kansas. Thanks to goals by Carlos Schweckerman, Christian Sanchez Ortiz, Victor Luingo, and Swave Maruth, each with a goal there. And also in goal today was Stefano Camlingo. Only had one save the entire match. Central Methodist had 17 shots there. Graceland, they're coming off a thrilling victory this past Tuesday over Grandview, 2-1 in overtime. It was 0-0 at halftime, then tied at 1 at the end of regulation, then Graceland won in overtime. Goals by Dawson Powers and Abraham DeLanda. Of course, after this, of course, the Central Methodist women's soccer team, they'll be taking on Graceland, 6:30 start time as well. And, of course, we'll have the pregame show about 6:15. There'll be I think Stephen Mann is going to be doing the play-by-play of that one there as well. And then, of course, this coming Tuesday night, the Central Methodist volleyball team will be taking on Mid-American Nazarene for a 7 o'clock start time. Pregame show at 6:45 p.m. Of course, early today over at Puckett Fieldhouse, the Central Methodist volleyball team defeated Benedictine 25-18, 25-18, 25-23 as well. And that third set, you remember, they were once down, I believe, like maybe 12-10, like 19-11 or so, and then they had a rally going. They got the next 10, make it 21-19, and then Benedictine got a point. And then, of course, Central Methodist pulled away for the 25-23 victory. They're 3-1 and two. And, of course, Central Methodist with that victory there, they are 4-1 and, of course, 2-1 in the conference as well. So a thrilling victory there. Of course, last I heard, now I can go check the score on that one. Of course, the Central Methodist football team, they were taking on Graceland as well down in Lamoni, Iowa. And, of course, Central Methodist, they jumped ahead 28-0 at the end of one quarter, 35-0, and it was 35-0 into the fourth, and I think it was 42-0 with about 2:43 to go. But let me check the stats here. Just to be sure. And ladies and gentlemen, that is the final score. Central Methodist 42, Benedict Graceland nothing. So Central Methodist 1-0. They'll be taking on William Penn next Saturday at 2 o'clock start time there. And hopefully we'll have I will probably do the play-by-play with the pregame show, maybe 1:45, maybe 1:30 or so with the kickoff show there. So good start for the Central Methodist football team. They are 1-0. What a thrilling victory there. So 42-0 victory there. And of course we'll take a timeout here in about 2 minutes. We will have the pregame show here on CMUEagles.com. you know what? Hey, Rachel. Hey, Ray. Hey, I was going to let you know I'm getting ready to hammer. How you guys doing there? Well, I'm good. Hey. Hey, it's great to see you as well. You know, it was a fun, hey, a fun victory there. Hey, it was a lot of fun. Looking forward, and I'll see you Tuesday as well. Well, it was a fun victory, and you guys have, it was great. Hey, guys, doing? Hey, a great win today. It was a great, fun victory. Hey, it was a fun victory today. You know, it was a fun, hey, it was a fun game. It was a fun game there. Hey, a good effort there. Team played really great, yeah. Well, it was great to see you guys. Have a great day. Hey, good to see you. We're back here at Arthur Davis Field. We're just about ready to get started. Central Methodist hanging on Graceland. It's a home opener. So Central Methodist men's soccer, the two-time defending NAIA men's soccer championship. If they go back, they will have to wait until April. Until April. Should be a lot of fun today. So we're about ready to get started. The captains meet out on the 50-yard line. Quentin Norris calling from the catbird seat here at Davis Field. Just a beautiful day as we're heading toward the start of fall in about, I would say, in about 3 days or so. Boy, it's just a nice day for it. I think temperatures, and I think in the about in the 70s as well. Should be a fun game there. Beautiful, crisp day. Boy, fall is here. Of course, also tonight, the Kansas City Royals taking on the Milwaukee Brewers. 6 o'clock start time. Also, the St. Louis Cardinals take on the Pittsburgh Pirates in game number 4 of that 5-game series as well. Game 4 of the 5-game series. Boy, the Cardinals got a doubleheader sweep yesterday, 6-5, and then 7-2. Of course, if in that game, in the bottom of the sixth inning, the Cardinals scored Would you believe this? It's six runs in the bottom of the sixth inning. They were down 2-1 and won it 7-2. So we're about ready to get started. We're about 2 minutes, under 3 minutes away from the start of the soccer match. Of course, I'll have the men's game, and I think Stephen Mann may have the women's game. Of course, the men's soccer team, their next game after today, they'll be hosting Mid-American Nazarene Wednesday night at 7:30 start time as well. So we're about ready to get started. We're probably going to have the prayer, national anthem, then starting lineups. Thank you. Well, we got the starting lineups for both teams. Quentin Norris in the catbird seat for today's men's soccer matchup. Graceland 3-0 and 1-0 in the conference. Central Methodist 1-0 and 1-0 in the conference there. Of course, tomorrow we got some NFL football doubleheader action on CBS. Some of the featured ones, Buffalo and Miami, Denver, Pittsburgh, Jacksonville, Tennessee as well. And then the late cappers are, of course, Baltimore and Houston, and, of course, the Kansas City Chiefs and the Los Angeles Chargers. We're ready to get started. Graceland is in the Navy uniform, white trim, white numerals. Central Methodist is in the white uniforms, green trim, green numerals. Birds on the bats. Central Methodist head coach is Alex Nichols, and, of course, Graceland's head coach, Brian Courtney. The two-time defending NAIA men's soccer championships. They won their championship defeating Hastings 3-1 there last December, on December the 7th of 2019. As we're underway now, Graceland will have it. A little pop-up action there. Let's see where it goes. Graceland's still in control there. Keeping alive is Central Methodist. Here comes Graceland there. And a throw-in coming up there for Central Methodist. See where they line up at around the 15-yard line. Throws it in there. Nice throw-in. And the goalie has it for Graceland. Looks like Liam Smith for Graceland. A little pop-up action. Here comes Graceland, but taken away by Central Methodist. And coming up with it for Central Methodist is Stefano Camarengo. Of course, the goalie from Italy. Right around the Venice area. Famous for riding a boat ride where you can take a trip on a boat. Here comes Graceland with it. Graceland tries to keep it in control. Gets across the 40. Here comes Graceland. Graceland on the left side. They're moving along that left side there. They keep pushing along the 20. Here comes Graceland there. Keeps it in control. Gets it to the middle of the field there. Just underway. And it's number 22 for Graceland. But Central Methodist will keep it alive there. And looks like, no, Graceland will stay with it. Moves it back up there, tries to reset that offense there. But Central Methodist tries to keep it away, but it'll be a Graceland throw-in coming up there with 42:40 to go, first half action. Here comes Graceland. Look at him move across that 20-yard line. Here comes Graceland. Sets it up. Beautiful save! And now they'll punt. Beautiful end and over end punt there. Here comes Graceland. Graceland will have it. They'll keep it in control there. Back comes, let's see what they're going to call it. A throw in for Graceland with just about 3 minutes gone by in this first half action there. Throw it in. And a throw in for Central Methodist. Here's the throw in. Keeps it alive there. Here comes Central Methodist with it. Here comes down inside that 20-yard line. Here comes Central Methodist on that right side there. Let's see what they do here. It looks like a corner kick. Our first corner kick of the night. That was at 41-13 to go in the first half. All right, fans, it's time for a corner kick. A Central Methodist corner kick, sponsored by Braun Funeral Home. They set it up there on that right side. Let's see what they come up with. Left-footed shot there. Here's a shot, knocked away. Graceland tries to stay with it, but Central Methodist has it. Another line drive shot there. Here comes Graceland. Look at Lelengo. Oh, got it on the 30. Gets off a beautiful punt. Back comes Central Methodist. That's number 14 with it. Here comes their line drive shot. Saved by Graceland. Graceland to have it. We're just about 40 minutes gone. 5 minutes gone by. First has 0-0. Central Methodist had a corner kick just a minute ago or so. Here comes Graceland with it. Graceland on the attack. Beautiful job there by Central Methodist. Let's see what Central Methodist does here. Keeps it alive, but Graceland looks like maybe a goal kick coming up there with 39:33 to go, first half action. 0-0 score. If you're just joining us, the Central Methodist football team defeated Graceland 42-0 down in Lamoni, Iowa. And at the same time, Central Methodist volleyball team defeated Grace Benedictine 3-0, 25-19, 25-19, 25-23. And Tuesday night, the Central Methodist volleyball team takes on Mid-America Nazarene for a 7 o'clock start time, pregame show 6:45. Line drive kick. Here comes. Let's see what's. Oh, it's a foul call there against Graceland. So now Central Methodist will have it around the 29-yard line. They're in a I formation set. They'll set up the I. And getting ready to kick it. It's Victor Luengo, who has one of the goals there for Central Methodist. Came in that one against Benedictine. Gets off a beautiful line drive shot. Knocked away. Here comes Graceland. No, Central Methodist will retain the possession. Here's a left-footed shot. And it looks like a goal kick coming up for Graceland. With 38:04 to go in the first half, Quentin Norrising in the catbird seat. Line drive, kick. Nice header, another header. Third header. Keeps it alive there, here comes. A little tangled up. No call there. And this time it will be a throw in for Central Methodist. And throwing it in for Central Methodist, number 20, Marcos Garman from Madrid, Spain. Off the head. Here comes Central Methodist with it. There's number 23 with it. Gets it on that right side. It gets it across the 20. Down to the 10. Floats it into the middle. There. Let's see if Central Methodist can have a chance with a goal. Oh! It hit the top of the net. And it'll be a goal kick here. Boy, Central Methodist had have an opportunity. They had the goalie out of position and missed it by a header. There's the kick. Line drive kick. Back comes Grono. Let's see what the call is. It looks like maybe a foul call there. Now Graceland will have it. Around the 42, they're going to mark it at the 43-yard line. On the Central Methodist's 43-yard line. Line drive kick. Here comes Central Methodist with it. They clear it out. And it'll be a throw in for Graceland. Now throwing it in for Graceland is Connor Wallace. Directs the traffic, throws it in. Line drive, and here comes Central Methodist with it. Moving across the middle of the field. Oh, Central Methodist player slipped. And now throw in for Graceland with 35-13 to go, first half action. Line drive, throw in. Here comes Central Methodist. Back comes Graceland. And looks like a throw in for Central Methodist. There's a throw in. Tangled up and a foul call there with 34:26 to go. So now kicking it is Victor Duango from Madrid, Spain. Directing the traffic. They'll have it around the 30. Low line drive kick. Here comes Central Methodist with it. See what they do here. Maybe a handball, but they said go on, but Central Methodist retains it. Luengo sets it up. Line drive floater. Here's the shot. And it's a corner kick. 43-41 to go. A Central Methodist corner kick. Second of the day. And on to take the corner kick, it looks like it's Marcos Gurman. He is a line drive, left footer. Here's the left footed kick, line drive. Up in the air. Who has it? Still loose. Here's the shot. Oh, another corner kick. The third of the day with 32:59 to go. The third one for Central Methodist. And I think the shots, if you look at it, maybe 4-1 now. Gurman again. Left footed kick. Here's the shot. And it'll be a goal kick coming up for Graceland. But you know what? They've been having some opportunities, but I'm sure sometime later on they will get the goal. A line drive kick. And looks like maybe a foul call there with 32 minutes to go. So Central Methodist will have it on their own 45-yard line. Two back set. Here's the line drive, booming kick. Knocked away by Graceland, but here comes Central Methodist. Good recovery there. Throw in coming up for Central Methodist. 31:20 to go. And throwing in is Isaac Johnson from Jefferson City. When you see him, he looks like Isaac the bartender from the TV show The Love Boat. And that'll be a corner kick, I do believe, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see what the call is. It is a corner kick with 38 to go. And this will be the fourth one of the day. There's the kick. Knocked away. Central Methodist has it. But it's wide to the right, and it'll be a goal kick for Graceland. Thirty minutes ago, first half. Throw in for Graceland. Another line drive kick coming up with under 30 minutes to go in the first half. Here comes Graceland with it. Nice job there by Central Methodist on the recovery. Back comes. Now Graceland has it, but it'll be an offside call with 29:15 to go there in the first half. Here comes Central Methodist with it. Let's see what they do here. That'll be a foul call there with 28:55 to go. So now let's see what Victor Dwingo will do here on the 25-yard line. They'll set it up here. Line drive kick. Nice save by the goalie. That's Liam Smith from Essex Inga, but stolen away by Central Methodist. Look at him go. Keeps it in the middle of the field. Left footed pass. Knocked away. And Liam Smith will have it. With 28 minutes to go. He is from Essex, England, the same area where the great Richard Dawson was from. You may know him as the very first host of Family Feud. And a throw in coming up there, and in to throw it in is Marcos Gurman. He'll have it around the 48-yard line. They'll set it up there. 27:45 to go. Gurman bounces it up there. Here comes Graceland, knocked away. Oh, stolen air. Good pass. Here's the shot. Knocked away. Another corner kick. Ladies and gentlemen, I have five corner kicks in the first half with 27:26 to go in the first half. I'm sure our statistician will give me some updates as well. I'm sure Lucy, Rachel, all those will give me a stats as well. 27 minutes to go. Corner kick coming up. Here's the kick. Line drive. Knocked away. And it looks like a goal kick coming up for Graceland. Here's a line drive kick. Central Methodist will have it. Tangled up, and it'll be a foul call there on Central Methodist with 26:21 to go. Central Methodist will have, actually Grayson will have it on the Central Methodist's 48-yard line. 26 minutes ago in the first half. Want to wish President Drake a happy birthday. sure President Drake enjoyed the volleyball match, and I'm sure he enjoyed watching the football team defeat Graceland. And now he's sure watching the men's soccer team in action. Line drive there. Here comes Graceland. They'll reset that offense there. Get to the back. Nearly knocked away. Nice hustle there by Central Methodist. But Graceland stays with it. And now a throw-in coming up there for Graceland. 25:09 to go, first half. Knocked away, and looks like a throw-in for Central Methodist. Hey, another line drive kick there. Let's see what's going to happen. Bouncing. Nice bicycle kick set up there. And it'll be a Graceland throw-in. With 24:29 to go, first half action. Here comes Graceland with it. They keep it alive. Oh, nice sliding tackle there. And Central Methodist will have it. Let's see what they do here. There comes a little roller, but nice hustle there. I think that was Carlos Scheckerman with the hustle. In that game against Benedictine on Wednesday night, Central Methodist led 3-0 at the end of the first half. And then they added one more in about the 17-minute mark as well. There's the throw in. Knocked away. Nice header. Another header. Now they set it up there. And that's number 14. And looks like our first yellow card has been announced with 23:19 to go. See who gets, looks like it's on Graceland. So Marcos Gurman will kick it off. Gurman, and as they set it up there, there you look at number 7. That is Isaac Johnson. And, you know, he is the freshman. We have a new nickname starting today. He is known as the bartender. Almost knocked away, and I think it may be a corner kick coming out. And the reason why I'm calling him the bartender, because he looks like Isaac the bartender from The Love Boat. The television show The Love Boat. As Victor Dwingo will have the corner kick with 22:52 to go. Let's see if they can get on the scoreboard here. Knocked away by Graceland, but here comes Central Methodist. The part. And here comes the Wingo. Now Graceland will have it. Knocked away, but here comes Graceland. And it looks like an offside is the call there. With 22:25 to go. Here's the kick. Beautiful kick. Here comes Graceland with it. Knocked away. Back comes Central Methodist. Trying to clear it out, and they'll. Looks like a goal kick coming up there. Goal kick coming up with 21:41 to go. And looks like our substitution, our first one tonight. Hunter Gilliam from Neosho, Missouri checks into the ball game there. line drive kick. And looks like a throw in for Graceland. As Connor Wallace will throw it in. Alex Nichols giving out the instructions. Two-time NAIA Coach of the Year. Left-footed kick. I think they're now, it's interesting, in the preseason poll, they're ranked number one, but it's going to be interesting where they're going to be ranked when the new polls come out, hopefully in the next few weeks or so. Graceland still has it around the 10-yard line. Keeps it away there. Here comes. And interesting, no, this will be the first time in about 3 years since I have ever broadcast a Central Methodist men's soccer game. And the last time I did broadcast, I think it was when they were playing, I think it was Mount Mercy, and it was like the last regular season home match or something. But I can remember another memorable women's soccer one just happened this week, just about 3 years ago this week, when Central Methodist upset Benedictine on a bicycle kick goal by Lucy Brazel. I'm sure Lucy still remembers it that day. They gave Central Methodist a 3-1 victory there, and that, and then the following Tuesday, they were ranked for the first time in school history. And now in the throwing in is Isaac the bartender Johnson. There's Isaac throwing in a beautiful throw in. And the goalie, Liam Smith, has it. And let's see what the call is. A corner kick. Oops. Corner kick coming out with 19:11 to go. That was a tough one. Here's a counter kick shot there, and it's out of play. It's either Isaac the bartender, or we could have called he kind of looks similar to Ricardo Montalban, who used to be on Fantasy Island. And now substitution in for Central Methodist as Isaac Johnson comes out. Here's the kick. And Central Methodist, no, here's a knocked away. And let's see, it'll be a throw in for Graceland with 18:05 to go. No score. Quentin Norris hanging the catbird seat. Left-footed kick, knocked away. Also tomorrow night, we've got some Sunday night baseball. The Minnesota Twins hanging on the Chicago Cubs. The final Sunday night regular season game. Boy, the baseball season's starting to wind down. I think we got about eight days ago now. Boy, it's been a crazy one. Now with the pandemic and everything, of course, with the settlement, boy, it's been a long sprint. And now here comes Central Methodist on the attack. Let's see what they do here. Good pass. Here's the shot. Oh, it's blocked. But Graceland caves the Y with it 17 minutes ago. Well, let's see what the call is. I think it'll be a throw-in for Graceland. Connor Wallace will throw it in. Of course, the women's team will play later on tonight. They're 0-1. They lost to Benedictine 3-2 on Wednesday night down in Atchison, Kansas. Of course, last year, they had a terrific season. I think they finished the year like 22-0-1. What an amazing year, and I think they're going to be a good team to watch out for under head coach Dan Schmidlin. Even though they lost a lot of good players, including Yudis Sains, but they still have some good ones. Sarah Kabul. Of course, I've course, been known to send messages. Of course, sent her a message a few times during the summertime. Of course, was doing all right, and now looking forward to it, along with Annika Collier, Ellie Buffet. And I think Ellie and Annika, they've been a really big part of this program. This is their senior year. Boy, they've done great things there during those 4 years, as well at Central Methodist. Back comes Graceland with it, with under 16 minutes to go. No score. Graceland will have it around the 43-yard line, 15 and a half minutes to go. On the 41-yard line, they'll set it up. Line drive kick, knocked away by Central Methodist. Nice bicycle kick. Another trying to set up a bicycle kick, a little pop-up, but Graceland, that'll go out of bounds, a throw in for Central Methodist. And throwing it in is Marcos Gurman. Marcos German. He will throw it in. Beautiful throw in to number 14. Nice pass. They said, here's the shot. Wide right. And now some substitutions there. For Graceland is number 9, Leon Belonga Chirombe. And number 2, Keely McCann. McCann. Also for Central Methodist, number 16. Oh, wrong one there. Of course, number 2 is Moise Alonde, and then Reynos Jane Pirani. And for Central Methodist, that's Sylvain Murr and Ramos Swenson. Back to live action there. Here comes Central Methodist with it. So it looks like a goal kick coming up with 13 and a half minutes to go. No score so far. Here's the kick. Let's see who gets to it. Foul call there with 12:48 to go. So Central Methodist will have it at the 42, and there that's Victor Dwingo. Line drive kick, beautiful kick. Here comes Central Methodist with it. He's trying to stay in bounds, and offsides is the call there with 12:09 to go in the first half. So Graceland will throw it in. Line drive. Keep it alive. And a foul call with 11:49 to go. I think Stephen Mann is going to do the women's game tonight. Now they tell him to move it back 5 yards for a false start. 11:26 to go.
could have called him.
Nice header. And a holding foul there on Graceland with 11:07 to go. So Central Methodist will have it on the 47-yard line. They'll line up in a two tight end set. And now again, the kick is Victor Luengo. Here's a booming kick, and it'll be a goal kick coming up for Graceland. Ten-20 to go, first half, no score. Line drive kick. Off the head. Nice job there. Good pass. Here comes number 22 with it. He looks like Doug Flew. Here comes number 22. They give it out there. Trying to set up that offense. Gets through there, but Graceland will have it under 10 minutes to go, first half. Nice job there, and I think maybe a corner kick, I do believe, or no, maybe a goal kick coming up. 9.5 minutes ago, no score. Quentin Norris here from the Davis Field. Just joining us, or Central Methodist football defeated Graceland 42-0. They're 1-0. They'll be taking on William Penn next Saturday. 2 o'clock start time, pregame show about 1:30. Then the Central Methodist volleyball team, they took care of Benedictine. They won it 25-18, 25-18, 25-23. They're 4-1 and 2-1 in the conference. They'll take on Mid-American Nazarene Tuesday night, 7 o'clock start time. Foul has been called with 8:55 to go. On the Graceland 48-yard line. Left-footed kick, booming line driver. Nice job by Liam Smith. Boy, he jumped up high like Lynn Swan would do for the Pittsburgh Steelers. And offsides is a call. Coming at 8:26 to go. Let's see where Central Methodist will have it. Around the... Moves it back to their own 40, maybe 43-yard line, I do believe. 8 minutes ago. A lot of the action has been taking place on Central Methodist end of the, on Graceland's side of the field there. A few times they've been in Central Methodist's territory, but Central Methodist defense has stopped them. A little tangled up, but a foul call there. So now Central Methodist, so Grace will have it on their own 27-yard line. Actually, 28-yard line, 7:20 to go, first half. Graceland is directing the traffic. Line drive kick. Nice job there, but a Graceland player fell down, and I'm sure he's okay. So throw in for Graceland. comes Graceland. And looks like a throw-in for Graceland. 6-0, about 6 minutes ago, first half, 0-0. Line drive. Now let's see what Central Methodist recovers it. Brings it back out. See what they do here. There's number nine, but it's knocked away, intercepted by Graceland with 5:28 to go. Oh, nice hustle there. Alexander LeCarey. And nice jump up there by Liam Smith. Like I say, he reminds you of Lynn Swan doing that for the Pittsburgh Steelers. And he booms a kick. Nice header there. But Graceland has it. Gets it back. Another header. Central Methodist has it. And a foul called with 4:48 to go. Another Graceland player down, I'm sure, shaking up a little bit. Hey, he looks okay, so. We're about 4 minutes away from the half. 4 minutes to go in the first half. 0-0. Well, I tell you one thing. You look at the corner kicks. I have like 7 corner kicks for Central Methodist. Line drive kick. The farthest one they've been is around the 10, now inside that 10, and looks like a foul called. Graceland player wants to plead, and now Central Methodist gets back to it. They'll direct that offense there. Booming kick. 3.5 minutes to go. Let's see if Central Methodist can get a goal here. And a throw-in coming up for Graceland with 3:15 to go. Very entertaining first half. Pretty good crowd on hand. Beautiful weather. Got some Dodger blue skies. Nice line drive kick there. Beautiful kick. Sets it up by Johnson. Here comes Central Methodist. .235 to go now. Foul call with 2:29 to go on Graceland. Central Methodist will have it around the 50-yard line. Alex Nichols directs the traffic. Line drive kick. And Liam Smith has it with 2 minutes to go. Falls down for a second, but he recovers it. Booming kick. And looks like a throw-in coming up for Graceland with 100 seconds left. Nice job there. Good job by Central Methodist. Keeping alive with 88 seconds left. Passes it. Knocks it down. A foul called. Time call there. Only one yellow. training staff will come out there, check to see if he's okay. By that time, Central Methodist will use one of their three timeouts there to maybe come up with a strategy. Maybe come up with a play for Marco Gurman. Maybe like run, makes have one of them run a post pattern. Like run a little post route there, or maybe one for Carlos Scheckerman. He can run a go route. Let's see what that Alex Nichols has on his playbook. Left footed kick around the 50. Booming kick. Line drive there. Foul call with 68 seconds left. So with 1 minute to go in the first half, seconds left. Liam Smith tries to direct that offense. Remember, Graceland still has one of their three timeouts. Line drive kick. Let's see what they call is, and a throw in for Central Methodist with 30 seconds left. Gurman will throw it in. Alex Nichols directing the traffic. Gets out to the goalie. Carmingo, booming kick. 13 seconds. Line drive kick. First half comes to an end. It's 0-0 here on CMUEagles.com. Bart. Central Methodist had some chances in the first half, but couldn't get through. But I'm sure Coach Nichols has talked to him. Maybe hopefully we can get some goals here. They have really maintained a lot of the possession, especially on Graceland's end of the field. Now let's see what Graceland does here. Central Methodist will have it. Now it's taken away. Here's the kick. Line drive kick. But here comes Graceland. Back comes. Nice job there by Stefano Caramengo. Now let's see what Central Methodist does here. Keep it in control is Billy Nobangi, Wangi. And now, here comes Graceland. And it'll be a throw-in coming up. And now throwing it in, number 23, Alessandro Licardi. Licardi throws it in. Knocked away. Here comes Central Methodist with it. And that's German. And now here comes, see what Central Methodist does here. Key to the control. Good pass. They set it up perfectly. Luongo. Here's Luongo. Good pass. Here's the shot. But Central Methodist keeps to the control there. See what they do here. Shot. Looks like a corner kick coming up there with 22:04 to go. First corner kick of the second half for Central Methodist. Let's see if they can cash it in there. They had about seven of them in the first half. Here's the kick. Knocked away. Here's the kick. Central Methodist in control. Line drive, and it's taken away. Here comes Central Methodist with it. Knocked away. And the goalie will have it. Throws it a little screen pass. And let's see what Graceland does here. Taken away. And looks like a foul call there. Comes with 40-19 to go. line drive kick. Here comes Central Methodist with it. Sets it up there. Good pass. Let's see what they do here. Shot is blocked. Rebound knocked away. Nearly 39 minutes to go. A corner kick coming up. Passes it out there. Here's a shot knocked away. Shot is blocked. But here comes Graceland. Sliding tackle. Stays in bounds. Looks like one of the Graceland players lost a shoe. Here comes Graceland there. Shot. Knocked away. Central Methodist clears it out. Beautiful job. Nice kick there. Nice job there. But here comes Graceland on the bounce. Good job there is Gerton. As Lasardi. Lasardi, here's the shot. Saved by Smith. Beautiful shot there. With 37:39 to go. Line drive kick. Nice job by the goalie. Good hustle there. On a backwards pass trying to set it up, but the goalie knocked it away. Beautiful play there. And I believe this will be the first corner kick of the night for Graceland. Here's the kick, blocked, knocked away. Here's the shot, and it's over the goal post, and a goal kick coming out with 36:34 to go. Nice kick. Here's the bartender, good pass. Here's the shot, goal! Goal! One to nothing. 36:15 to go. Of course, after this, the women will play. It'll be a 30-minute break in between. One. 7-0 Central Methodist on the goal by Christian Sanchez Ortiz, his second of the year. Beautiful play on the bounce. Directs the traffic. Booming kick. Here comes Central Methodist with it. Let's see if they can get another one. Maybe add some cushion there. Line drive kick over the goal pole. Liam Smith will kick. Line drive kick. Beautiful job there. Let's see what Central Methodist does here. Keeps in control. Central Methodist player slipped, but recovered. Here comes Central Methodist. Looks like a throw-in coming up for Graceland. 1-0 Central Methodist. Came with 36:15 to go to give the Eagles a 1-0 lead there. Here's the throw in. Beautiful throw in. A pushing call, but they keep playing on. Here comes Graceland. Throw in coming up there. Foul call there. Here's the kick. Nice job there. Good hustle by Carmengo. See what's going on there. We're 32:57 to go. Another line drive kick. Push there. Thirty to go. Now time call. To go, 1-0 Central Methodist. a line drive kick. Line drive popped up. Clears it out. But Central Methodist hustles. Good hustle there by German. By German. Here comes Graceland with on the attack. There he goes inside the 20, the 10. Good job by Central Methodist knocking away. And I think it was Tom Iron. Great hustle there. .31-30 to go, a Graceland corner kick. Line drive kick. Header. Stays with it, clears it out. And now substitution there. It is Connor Wallace checking into the game. Under 31 minutes to go. 1-0 lead there. Came with 36:15 to go on a goal by Christian Ortiz. Sanchez Ortiz. Stays with it. That's Lissardi. Out to Ortiz. Ortiz, who scored earlier. Ortiz steals it! Ortiz, wow! Boy, he looks like Curly. He's like Curly Neal would do for the Harlem Globetrotters. And it looks like a corner kick coming up with 29:42 to go. I remember this about 3 years ago. They had a Central Methodist women's soccer team had a corner kick against Benedictine. A bicycle resulted in a bicycle kick goal by Lucy. Lucy Brazel. Here's the corner. And a foul call there with 29:17 to go. Here's a line drive kick, and here comes Central Methodist. Another line header. Another header. Header. Foul call there. Looks like an injured Graceland player is down on the field. So Central Methodist will have it on the Graceland 46-yard line. 28:35 to go. 1-0 Central Methodist. Quentin Norris in the cap jersey. Of course, the women's game will follow about 6:30 or so. Of course, Stephen Mann will probably have the women's game. Line drive kick. And it's caught by Liam Smith. drive kick. And the goalie has it with under 28:25 to go. Line drive kick. Nice job there. Let's see what Central Methodist does here. Slip, but he recovers it. Line drive. Oh, nice job by the goalie. Smith recovers it. Alex Nichols wants a call. He's not going to get it. Line drive kick. Offsides is a call. 27:33 to go. Here's the kick by Central Methodist. A low line drive kick. Spinner. Nice header there. Sets it up. Nice kick. To number 15. That's Luingo. Luingo. And some substitutions for Graceland. That is Moise Natabi and Renanzo Jean-Pierre. One nothing is their score. Game on the goal by Christian Santos Ortiz, his second of the year. Staying with it. Here's a screen pass. Booming kick there. Header. Another header. Bicycle kick. Gets it out to the bartender. Here's number 22 with a shot. Knocked away. With 25:15 to go. Corner kick coming up for Central Methodist. Here's a left-footed kick. In the area, but Central Methodist, see, they have it. Ortiz. Throwing coming up. 24:33 to go. There'll be a 30-minute break, and then the wind will play Graceland. I think the women's team should be warming up by now. Here's the bartender. Out to German. Back out to the goalie. 24 minutes to go. Line drive kick. Here is number 14. Knocked away. Tries to rebound. Stays with it. I think it's a corner kick coming up with 23:47 to go. left side there. Let's see what they come up with. Ortiz expecting a draw play. Line drive kick. Knocked away. Here comes German. Knocked away. Here's the bartender. The bartender sets it up here. Nice bicycle kick. Let's see what the call is. Here's the throw in. Keeping alive here. Nice move there. Here's number 14. Here's his shot. Knocked away. Graceland stays with it. Good recovery by Central Methodist. Nice sliding tackle. Stopping the clock at 22:11. Line drive kick. Good floater out to Ortiz. Nice sliding tackle and save by Liam Smith. Throw-in coming up for, looks like a throw-in for Graceland. Bicycle kick. Sets it up for the bartender. Out to Ortiz. Ortiz. To number 14. Here's a good low line drive shot. Taken, cleared out by Graceland. See what Graceland does here. Some substitutions for Central Methodist. Number 9 is Jayton Johnson. And number 6, Oscar Felt. Oscar Fletton. And throwing it in for Graceland's Dylan Fox. 20 minutes to go. 1-0 Central Methodist. Ortiz on the header. That's number 14 with it. And now a throw in for Central Methodist and a substitution there. Now they bring in Fletton and Johnson. Gets it back out to the goalie. Booming kick there. There's another kick there, but here comes Central Methodist. Looks like Johnson. Shot saved by Liam Smith. Another booming kick there with 19 minutes to go. Here comes Graceland with it. 18:45 to go. Shot wide right. Oh, my. So 18:28 to go. A Graceland corner kick. I believe this is the second one this half and the second for the game. Actually, the third one this half and all of them in this ball game. 18 minutes ago, 1-0 Central Methodist. Line drive kick. So now a substitution for Central Methodist. So when Mathru checks into the game, he scored one of the goals on Wednesday against Benedictine. 17 and a half minutes ago, 1-0 Central Methodist. Goal came with about 36:15 to go. Line drive kick. Keats in control. Here comes Central Methodist with it. And a throw in for Central Methodist. Here's the throw-in. Knocked away. Shot over the goal. Over the crossbar. Throw-in for Graceland. With 16:23 to go. Looks like a foul coming up there against Central Methodist with 15:54 to go. Kick away there. Offsides is a call there with 15:32 to go. Line drive kick. Nice move there, tackle. And the bartender couldn't keep it in control there. Good effort there by Isaac Johnson. Here comes Central Methodist. Line drive kick. Central Methodist will throw it in with 14:17 to go. Women's soccer team getting ready to get set up. Here's the throw in. Knocked away. Another one. Let's see what's going on there. It'll be a corner kick coming up for Central Methodist. 13:54 to go. Here's the shot and a goal! 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 Tom Arion gives Central Methodist a 2-0 lead. Two nothing Central Methodist. Well, that's huge there. Anytime you have a 2-goal lead, it makes things more simple. Makes things a little more difficult. Ortiz. Here comes Graceland there, but a nice clear out by Central Methodist. 13 minutes ago. Here's a shot, and it's into the goal with 12:55 to go. Now it's 2-1 now. A goal by Moises Debate. Throwing coming up there. 12:40 to go. Could they hang on? I think Central Methodist need to come up with another goal just to make it a 2-goal game. Stopping the clock at 12:39. Some substitutions for Central Methodist. It looks like number 8, Lucas Pardo and Hunter Gilliam. We'll be ready to check in shortly. There's a booming kick there, trying to set it up for the bartender. Bartender tries to keep it in control. And a foul call there with 11:55 to go. Here's a booming kick. comes. See who gets it. Graceland has it. Kate's in control, but Graceland has it. 0-0, but since Central Methodist scored a goal by Christian Ortiz. By Christian Ortiz, making 1-0. And then number 5, Tom Earing, got his first goal of the year. 2-0, and then Graceland scored about 41 seconds later to make it 2-1 now. Shot is kept in control by Liam Smith. 10:45 to go. Line drive kick. Here comes Central Methodist with it. Johnson sets it up there, but Johnson gets it knocked away. Foul. It looks like a holding is the call. Stopping the clock with 10:12 to go. Trying to hang on to this one goal lead. So now a 4-man wall has been set. Here's the kick, and it's over the goalie, and it's now with 10 minutes to go. 2-1 Central Methodist trying to hang on. Women's soccer game to follow a little after 6:30. Should be a lot of fun there. I think Stephen Mann is going to have the play-by-play. Nine:20 to go. Both teams are warming up. Here's the bartender. Hands it off to German. German, left-footed kick. Sets it up. And it looks like a goal kick coming up for Graceland. And the clock ticking down to 8:50 to go. I think for Central Methodist, they want to try to do is limit the possessions for Graceland. And looks like a corner kick coming up with 8:40 to go. Would it be nice to get a third goal here to make it another two-goal game? There's a left-footed kick. Shot. It's into the net! Sheckerman gets Central Methodist a 3-1 lead, his second of the year. And that is huge right there. Now it's a two-goal game. With 8:23 to go. So a two-goal game now. Throwing coming up. Clock ticking down. 8:10. Seven 40 to go. Throwing coming in for Central Methodist. Another line drive kick there. Foul called with 8:701 to go. Clock is ticking down. Rodriguez on the kick on the Central Methodist 40. Line drive kick. Good job by German to clear it out. Here comes Graceland. But Central Methodist will clear it out. Line drive kick. Offsides is a call. It's 5:45 to go. Christian Sanchez Ortiz will get ready to check in. Taken down to the 5-minute mark. Line drive kick. And looks like a corner kick coming up for Graceland. 4:48 to go. Stops the clock at 4:37. Looks like the officials are trying to step in there. Be a little after 6:30 before the women's soccer game gets started. And looks like Stephen Mann will have the play-by-play. Line drive kick. And it's into the goal. 4:31 to go. They're not not going away yet. Two now. Line drive kick. 4:19 to go. Central Methodist trying to do is milk some time off the clock. Take a lot of time off that clock there. Stop the clock with 3:54 to go. I think it'd be a yellow card. There's no question on Graceland. Boy, that is huge there. Central Methodist tries to do is take some time off the clock. And now Grayson will have with 3:34 to go. It was 0-0 at halftime. Central Methodist scored the first two goals. Grayson made it 2-1. Then Central Methodist added a third one. Then Grayson made it 3-2. Clock ticking away to 3:15. And a foul call. Should be getting started against the Pittsburgh Pirates, trying to keep their postseason hopes alive. Kansas City Royals hanging on to Milwaukee Brewers. Coming up with 2:35 to go. Line drive. Throw in for Central Methodist. Clock ticking down to 2:10 to go. Central Methodist trying to maintain the possession. But most importantly, take time off the clock. And now Graceland has to go 95 yards and about 1:53 to tie the game. Job by Central Methodist. Now they have to get the ball and try to take time off the clock. With 84 seconds left. Nice hustle there. Trying to clear it out. Tripping call. Plays on. 66 seconds left. go now. Clock is ticking down to 50 seconds. Stopping the clock with 50.4 to go. And let's see what Graceland can do here. They'll have the ball around the 17-yard line. They have to go 83 yards. And they have three timeouts. Knocked away. 40 seconds. Line drive kick. Seconds left. They can just hold on to it, and Central Methodist will be 2-0 on the. Now they'll stop the clock at 22.8. 18 seconds, and looks like Central Methodist has done it. They will win the match 3-2. They're 2-0 in the year, 2-0 in the conference. Graceland, they're 3-1, 1-1 in the conference. And that'll do it, the final score. Central Methodist, 3, Graceland, 2. Central Methodist, 2-0 in the year, they're 2-0 in the conference. Graceland, 3-1, 1-1 in the conference. Central Methodist's next game is Wednesday. They'll take on Mid-American Nazarene, 7:30 start time. The women's game will start at 5 o'clock. In about 30 minutes or so, we'll have the pregame show, and then the women's team will play. This is Quentin Norris saying so long. That's 2,000.